Today we'll be starting with a new chapter, Plant Growth and Development. A very simple chapter because we just have 4 days and then your summer break is going to start for 10 days. This simple chapter we are going to start because we'll be able to wind up in 4 days. Plant Growth and Development. See beta, growth is one of the most fundamental characteristics of living organisms around you. Though we know this is not an essential characteristic, if you remember in the first chapter I have told you, at times even non-living things grow, though the growth is a little different. So, I just said it is the most fundamental characteristic. I did not say it is a basic or essential characteristic. It is one of the most fundamental characteristics of living organisms around you. How would you define growth? See, growth is an irreversible, permanent change. It's a permanent change. What kind of a change is it? Obviously, it is increase. So, the better word would be, you're right, it's an irreversible, permanent increase in size. Okay? In size of an organ. Or its part, or even of an individual cell. Anything can grow. An organ can grow in size, a part of an organ can grow in size, or an individual cell can grow in size. So add up all these three things when you define. So how would you define it? It's an irreversible, permanent increase in size of an organ, a part of an organ, or an individual cell. Growth is accompanied by both anabolic and catabolic processes. If you remember, destructive and constructive processes, I have already done this with you in previous videos. So growth is accompanied by, whenever there is growth, both anabolic as well as catabolic reactions take place in an organism which lead to the growth process. If you can see on the board, it is written that plant growth is intermediate. What does it mean? See, in plants the growth is unique. Compared to animals, the plant growth is different. That is why we say the plant growth is unique. Why is it different? Because plants have the capacity for unlimited growth. Animals, they grow up to a certain span of time or a certain period of time. Whereas plants, we know, they have unlimited growth. And this is due to the presence of meristems. We have done about meristematic tissue, if you remember. So this is all because of the presence of which tissues? This is all because of the presence of meristems. The cells of these meristems have the capacity to divide. They keep on dividing, but the product which is produced by these meristems gradually loses the capacity to divide. All cells do not have the capacity to keep on dividing through entire life. Some of them, they become differentiated and acquire a specific function. So those which lose the capacity to divide, they differentiate themselves, they form the body of the plant. And others, that is the meristematic tissue, they keep on dividing, which contribute to the growth of the plant. This type of a growth, where new cells are always being added to the plant body by activity of meristems, is called open growth form or open form of growth. Open form of growth is what? The plant is always growing. How is it growing? New cells are always being added. And from where are they being added from? By the activity of meristems. The apical meristems are responsible for the primary growth of a plant. Primary growth means they lead to the elongation of the plant along their axis. So when a plant is getting elongated along its axis, this is primary growth. And which meristem is responsible? Apical meristem is responsible. In gymnosperms and in dicots, the lateral meristems, the vascular cambium and the cock cambium, they appear later. So they are leading to secondary growth. Which three things? Lateral meristems, vascular cambium and the cock cambium, they appear later. Later in which categories of plants? Gymnosperms and dicots. These are the meristems that cause increase in the girth. That means the width, the broad part of the plant. That is the girth, G-I-R-T-H. The primary growth was elongation. This is the secondary one. Secondary growth is actually the increase in girth. That is the increase in width. Second point which is very important about growth is that growth is measurable. At cellular level, growth is increase in what? It is actually the increase in the amount of protoplasm. But it is very difficult to measure protoplasm directly. So what do we do? We take up a quantity which is almost in the same proportion to protoplasm and we measure it, and this is how we measure the growth, because protoplasm growth amount cannot be measured directly. There are many parameters to measure the growth. What are the parameters? It could be increase in fresh weight of a plant, increase in dry weight of a plant, increase in the length of a plant, increase in the area occupied by a plant, increase in the volume of a plant, or increase in the cell number of a plant. Out of these, even one is taking place, all of these are parameters which indicate that growth is taking place in a plant. If you see one single maize root apical meristem, it can give rise to more than 17,500 new cells. just one apical meristematic cell, it can give rise to how many? 17,500 new cells in maize plant per hour. This is in 1 hour. Comparatively, if you see cells in a watermelon, they increase their size up to 3,50,000 times. So, if you see the ratio is amazing. It's there, it was 17,500 per hour. Here in watermelon, it is 3,50,000 times. So, in maize, the growth was expressed where? Growth was expressed in increase in cell number. I told you the cell number increases by 17,500. But in watermelon, the growth was expressed in increase in size. I said it increases 3,50,000 times. What are we trying to tell you? We are trying to tell you that growth can be expressed both in terms of increase in cell number or in increase in size of the cell. If you see the growth of the pollen tube, it is measured how? It is measured in terms of its length. So there are different parameters for checking the growth of different kind of organs. This is all. We'll be just studying about growth hormones again ahead in this chapter.